is working okay. I was having some trouble there with the PS4 broadcasting tonight. It kicked me off a few minutes into a stream, but it seems like this is going okay, so I'm gonna get cracking. I'm playing Mad Max today. So the reason I'm playing Mad Max is, first of all, I was taking a little bit of a Fallout break, because I'm pretty deep into Fallout 4 currently, but it's, you know, I've kind of hit a wall with it a little bit, so I wanted to play something else. And Mad Max is a super fun thing to play just for a change of pace from Fallout. So, gonna do some story missions, gonna do some open world stuff. Oh, buddy. Right now, though, I'm just sticking around in the open world because this is, in fact, an open world game. And a pretty dang fun one. Oh, I missed him. Oh, but now I'm dragging him. Okay, so what I'm doing right here... What happened? Oh, okay. What I'm doing right here is kind of the crux of... Have I still got this guy harpooned? I do. All right, buddy, you're coming for me then. So what I'm doing here is kind of the crux of what you do in Mad Max, or what the big appeal of it is. I'm going to let him go because that's not fun. The car combat's kind of the one thing this game does that nothing else does. Like, there's not really a big car combat scene. Oh, shit. I'm going to try and not die here. I'm still struggling with the art of... Where the hell am I? Oh, there I am. Okay. I'm still struggling with the art of playing video games and talking at the same time. A lot harder than originally anticipated. But yeah, so... Oh, buddy! Okay, I have to try and get this guy out of his car. But that's very difficult when you yourself are carless. There are no grenades or anything like that in this game. There's oil tankers that you can use to fuel your car and then also throw... Oh, here he comes. And also throw, like, a grenade, but they are hard to come by. And you can't store them in your inventory. You just kind of have to find them. Alrighty. So that's the end of that fight. Let's catch our breath here and actually... Okay, let's talk about this game. Okay, that caught me off guard. So basically, I mentioned there, I was playing Fallout 4. Kind of wanted to take a break from it because it's, you kind of have to be in a particular mood to play Fallout 4. And I was way into it for a while, and then I was like, I just need a little break. I need something a little bit more lightweight, a little bit more action-y, a little bit less kind of obtuse.
I don't mean to question your saintly methods, but the angel calls for our holy work to go on.
Silence. So yeah, anyway, so I was just looking for something a little bit different, just as a change of pace. And then I was like, you know what? Mad Max was really fun, and I didn't get very far into it. So for those of you who don't recall, this game came out the exact same day as Metal Gear Solid 5, a little game you might have heard of. And I, like most people, touched both of them, but ultimately I was like, I'm falling down the rabbit hole big time with Phantom Pain. And so that was the game I kind of sunk a lot of time into from September through October. And then Fallout came out in November. So I'm kind of looking for a break for Fallout, and I was like, this game's cool, let's revisit it. I kind of do want to finish it, I want to see it through, because I like a lot of things about it. And as of this recording, which is going on the 3rd of December, today and tomorrow, the 4th, this game is on sale on PSN. It is half price, I think, so it's €35, £30, and $30, I do believe. So yeah, I think this game at that price is hard to refuse. I would have trouble recommending it at full price, especially, you know, coming out when it did against Metal Gear. I think for £35 that this game is really fun. The car combat, which you saw a little bit of there, wasn't very good because I was fumbling because I was trying to talk and do it. The car combat is really, really, really cool. You've got Batman hand-to-hand combat, which, you know, either love it or you hate it. I really like it. Other than the car combat, it's a very atypical open-world game. As you progress through the story, you meet various warlords. They have bases. Go to those bases, and guess what? You'll get side quests. Go do the side quests. You'll get XP. You'll get currency. And you use that to buy equipment and upgrade your character. It is not anything revolutionary, but it all works. The cars handle great. The fighting is fun. Most of the tasks are pretty entertaining, even though they're kind of repetitive. It's your typical kind of, you know, good but not excellent open world game. So this little yellow marker on my map there at the bottom, that is a scavenging location. But I'm not going to jump down there because... Oh, wait. Oh, it's a cave of some kind. Okay. So, yeah, those the little yellow or gold hand icon, that is a scavenging location of some kind. Sometimes it's a cave, sometimes it's a camp, sometimes it's a shack. You don't really know until you get there. So let's cruise in here. There could be enemies here. There could not be. There could just be remnants of a camp. There's also a big upgrade system which pertains to the car and to Max himself.
Keep an eye out. No surprises. Burnt to ashes.
Oh yeah, so here's a cool thing. You can eat maggots off corpses for health. Isn't that charming? Yeah, so the health system in this game is a bit weird. You don't have regenerating health, which is like, I can't think of too many games this year I played that didn't have regenerating health. That seems like a trope that is just 100% permeated video games. But in this one, you have to drink water and eat food to replenish your health. It will not replenish on its own. Just let me loot this thingy here. So yeah. Alright, so there was just one thing here. I do like that little pop-up, because there are some locations that have a bajillion things to loot, and it's actually really cool that it pops up and says, oh shit. So it's nice that it tells you you've got the location fully looted. The storms in this game are kind of like the storms in the Fury Road movie. This is not a Fury Road game directly, but it is super similar to Fury Road. So it's lightning, it's, you know, you can't see shit in front of your face because it's a big thick storm. It looks gorgeous. This game in general, I think, looks pretty gorgeous, but the storms look really gnarly. Where is it coming from? Oh, there it is. Look at that. Look how cool that is. Oh man, that's cool. I've played this game for about 20 hours and I still think that stuff is pretty cool. Alrighty. Okay, see, now I cannot see. Oh man. It looks great, but I cannot see a thing in front of my face. Alrighty, let's get indoors here. I'm going to be very boring and go indoors for the moment.
Still we live! Thank you, Angel!
So, you know what? Before we go any further, let's talk about this guy who keeps piping up when I'm trying to speak. This is Chumbucket. The story in this game is pretty damn unremarkable. You're Mad Max. Mad Max wants solitude. He wants to go to a place of solitude. His car gets stolen. He wants vengeance for his car, he wants a new car, and he wants to go to his lonely place of solitude. That is basically it. There is nothing to it from what I've seen so far. But I do think some of the characters in this world are pretty cool, including this little fella, Chumbucket, who's your mechanic. He kind of reveres you and your car as some kind of like godly figure, and his dialogue is pretty amusing. I really, really like him. He's one of my favorite characters of the year. One of my favorite new characters, rather. So yeah. That storm outside, basically it's a lightning storm. Shut up! People keep interrupting me. Do they not know that I am broadcasting? Mad Max is not up for talking right now, so... Not much going on in here. But yeah, so those storms, I think if you hang out in those storms, there are lucrative rewards. There's loot and stuff that you can get. But didn't really feel like messing around with it because it's also really easy to die. I just wanted to take shelter for a little bit. So this is a base you discover fairly early in the story. Open world game set after the apocalypse. So of course the land is divided up amongst these warlords. They all have territories, they all have bases, and of course they all have missions. Go gather this resource for me, bring me weapons, bring me money, etc. Like I said, story-wise, this game isn't lighting the world on fire. It's all very rote. Is he talking to me? Cheers. What I can do here in this base is there are resources around the world: water, scrap, food, ammo. I can use them to build up this base, and so when I come back to this base, I'm topped up on food and ammo and stuff. So that's one reason to come back here, but the main reason was just to avoid the storm. So I have nothing to do here, so I'm actually going to go... Hey. it does that thing that I feel like all open world games do these days, which is it has a reputation system, and the NPCs, get this, they actually talk to you about your rep. I'm kind of bored of games doing that, mainly because it feels so ham-fisted. Like, these people just don't shut up about how cool I am. It's very much like my real life. So let's jump back in the car here, and hopefully everything's cool outside. It's quite possible I'm jumping. Okay, there we go. So as I was noting during the storm, what's that light off? Is that the sun? I guess so. As I was noting during the storm, this is a goddamn beautiful game. What do we got here? I mean, we've got great lighting effects, the dust and the dirt and everything. The cars are beautifully modeled. This is from the same developer as Just Cause, but it's like two different teams, so it's not strictly the exact same. But the kind of explosion physics and the destruction physics that they've been showing off for Just Cause are very much present here. When the car combat really kicks off, it looks amazing. The fire looks gorgeous. The debris scatters everywhere. It's super satisfying. So I was mentioning earlier that if you hang out during the storms, really valuable loot, can stumble across it. I haven't actually done this before. Oh, there you go. So I basically waited out the storm, and I guess the loot just happened to fall here. So that's good. Alrighty. Got 100 scrap. We got 100 scrap. And we got 100 scrap. Alrighty. Collect 3 boxes out of a scrap. Okay, yeah. So there's a lot going on here. So the scrap I'm collecting, that is kind of your one purpose, your all-purpose currency. You use it to upgrade Max, and you use it to upgrade your car. Interestingly, there's no money in the game. So even though you have a shotgun and a sniper rifle on the back of your car, you don't buy ammo. You don't trade. You don't buy anything. You just upgrade your character from a menu.
One of your long journeys inside your brain.
Yeah, shut up. So you don't upgrade. You don't buy things in this game, you just upgrade. I got confused there for a minute. So as you can see here, I got just under 800 scrap. So I can upgrade my car, or I can upgrade Max with either cosmetic items or kind of power-ups and skills. I kind of like that. It kind of adds a little bit to the tension of having to have to scavenge for ammo, because the guns in this game are kind of overpowered, so to kind of tone that down, the ammo is super limited, so you gotta constantly be scavenging. There is no one in this world you can go to buy ammo from, so that's kind of an interesting twist on the typical open world formula, and there's not a lot of those in this game. So I feel like I'm jaw-jacking an awful lot. That's because, as I said, it's a little bit tough here to kind of narrate and also play this very crazy, hectic game. What do we want to do? Let's take a look here at the map. So this is your map. Color-coded for, like, danger and how much I've cleared out of a particular area, etc. So we've got these yellow things that are scavenging locations. We have got, let me see, these balloons are your atypical Ubisoft-style towers you can climb to sync up the map to show you tasks, but also they are fast travel. So you can use these to fast travel around the map. And then you have bases. These are basically combat zones where you have to fight your way through, beat people up, steal their resources, and, you know, blow something up, or blow several things up, or beat a boss. This one is a top dog camp, it says, so that means there's a boss there. So you know what? I'm thinking actually we might do that one. Screw it. Why not? So let's fast travel here. So there's kind of two aspects of this. There's the car combat, and then there's the on-foot combat. Both are good. But the hand-to-hand combat is very Batman-y, it's very familiar. It's good, but it's not unique. Whereas the car combat is something that not too many games are doing these days, so I kind of like that a bit more. Where are we going here? Okay. So let's make a little trip here. Shit. So yeah, you got weather, you got day-night cycles, you got the usual open-world trappings. Oh, okay. So if you look there, bottom left at my my mini map.
Oh, as the lamp flickers, ready for another night of terror.
So if you look on the minimap, I have discovered a convoy route. And these... Okay, I'm going to take this marker off because I want to do the convoy here. These are the most Fury Road-like moments of this game. A sequence of cars... Oh, they're behind me, actually. A sequence of cars kind of escort a valuable target along this track. And it's up to you to ram the guards off the road and steal the goods for yourself. Are they doing a drive past me? Yeah. Okay. So that's not the convoy. You'll know the convoy will be marked. Okay, there it is on my map there. So yeah, when you see these big greasy black tire marks, that means you're on a convoy track. And you can see there the dust in the distance. See, that's really cool. There's so many visual cues like in this game, not just on the map, but in the actual game.
Forget not the grand mojo what sits on the hood.
Alrighty. So the sniper rifle has its uses, but obviously I did not do a great job there. Oh, come on, I'm getting my ass kicked already. Okay.
Oh.
Alright, I am failing really bad at the talking and playing the game thing. I really apologize if I am dropping the ball here. Shit. Okay, so I'm gonna have to make another go with this convoy and, not talk as much. So your buddy there, Chumbuck, and he fixes your car the second you get out of it. So that's cool. As I mentioned earlier, I have no grenades. I have no way of fucking this guy up from my feet. I can do that, though. Alrighty, everyone. I'm scrubbing it up here. I went to the bother of streaming this game just so I could embarrass myself by getting fucked up super bad. Alrighty. Let's try this again, shall we? So, so we're basically going against the traffic here, which is also probably a bad idea, but you're fucking... I'm not going to try and chase them. So Scrotus, obviously, with a stupid name like Scrotus, he is the main antagonist. So yeah, I mentioned there before, these convoys are the most Fury Road-like aspect of this game. Big series of cars, side by side, you're ramming them off the road, you're throwing explosives at them, you're shooting your shotgun, you've got guys jumping on your hood. These things are seriously, seriously cool. They're one of my favorite aspects of the game. I employed a terrible strategy by sitting in the middle of the road and trying to snipe them. So I'm gonna actually chill here by the roadside. You motherfucker. Oh! Okay. So yeah, I have a harpoon, by the way.
Fix it up.
On my way.
So yeah. So instead of doing the sniping thing in the middle of the road like an idiot, we're actually going to chill here for a little bit and wait for our buddy to fix the car, first of all. Which you can prompt him to do that when you're sitting still. I don't have to like get out of the car for him to fix it. So you can see there... yeah, you can see the dust cloud. That's going to... The convoy's going to roll through here soon. So yeah. So... I kind of mentioned there earlier when the convoy was rolling through. There's lots of nice visual cues in this game. You can see there the dust in the distance. That's the convoy on the way. You saw at the beginning of the stream the storm. The storm rolls in from a particular direction. It actually looks kind of stunning. I really like it. There are snipers in this game. And the way you notice a sniper is watching you is you'll see their lens flare, like flicker against your screen. So they just put a lot of work into... not just having big garish things on the screen, like you got health bars here, but other than that, they did some pretty good work of not just, you know, telling you that certain things are coming, and instead there's very nice visual effects to kind of let you know. I appreciated that. Oh, shit. So there are all kinds of vehicle types in this game. There are those flamethrower types. There are types with... Oh, okay. There are types with... See those guys getting ready to jump on me? I got some spikes on my car, so fuck them. Okay. So this is what I'm talking about when the game gets Fury Road-like. Alrighty. That's one car down. We're not going to make it, obviously, because we're on fire here. And the car will not auto-fix. And this guy, Chum Bucket, he won't fix it while it's in motion. You have to stop and then prompt him. Oh! So basically, I used my harpoon. Shit. So basically there, I used my harpoon to grab onto that flamethrower's oil tank. And then I just drove faster than it could handle, and I ripped it off and caused an explosion. So there is lots of that kind of thing in this game.
Moving closer. Get a move on.
So there's lots of, you know, innovation, lots of fun to be had. You're ripping doors off. You can use the harpoon to rip doors off, tires. You can rip drivers out of the driver's seat. That thing does not mess around. It's really, really cool. You know, there's lots of toys. Even though this game isn't as versatile as Just Cause, you can tell that the Just Cause guys, kind of had their hands all over it, because there's lots of fun toys in this game. You also have the Fury Road style thunder sticks, which are just like, you know, grenades strapped to sticks that people throw at each other from their cars. Those are super fun. You got nitrous on your car, obviously. I'm going to try and catch up to this convoy here. Generally speaking, if you take a car or two out, that is persistent. So when I catch back up to them, there should be down a car. But if you fall too far behind, or you leave and come back later, they'll obviously respawn and more people will be there. So you can't just chip away. Alright, so I'm going to use the harpoon again here. There you go. So the harpoon also has a quick pull. So I shot it once and then pressed the shoot button again to just retract it immediately, and that yanked off the guy's something from that guy's car. Yeah. So those idiots keep jumping on my car even though I have spikes. Alright, we got our shotgun. We got our boomstick. Let's use this because we got a lot of ammo. So ammo is sparse, but you know, for situations like this, like he's got four or five cars protecting him, so I'm gonna want to make liberal use of my ammo. This is not the time for holding back. Oh, buddy. Have some of that. So square is a ram button, X is boost, and I think I just took off that guy's tire. So let's go to our shotgun here, and we got slow-mo aim. I think they have a gas tank in the back of the- oh no, they have a guy. Let's go tire. Shit. Alrighty, aiming and driving is not my strength, just like talking and playing. Okay. Is he down to... Is he on his own? Or does he have one... He's got one guy left. So yeah. I mean, I could theoretically just attack him straight out. The goal here is just to destroy him and take his hood ornament. But it's just... It's impossible with that one car left, because he's going to ram me and hit me and run my ass over and... Oh! Shit. Okay, so he actually opted to leave me in my dust here rather than finish me off. So I pretty much just have to wait for Chum Bucket to fill that up.
I'd be done if I had some better tools.
Come on, buddy.
Vigilant, my angel.
All right, let's go. Let's go.
This is Red Island, and they mostly come at night. Yes.
I really like Chum Bucket. I think he's kind of funny and endearing. Maybe some people might think he's annoying. Okay, I think I'm pretty sure this actually might have reset. I'll be kind of frustrated if it has, but... There's no health pickup, or there is no way to recharge while you're in motion. So on harder convoys like this, it does make it really tough to take them down without having to stop like I've had to here a couple of times. Now, it could be a case of maybe I just need to level up my armor and stuff, because there is a pretty deep car upgrading system here, but, you know, they don't have any kind of level gate on them, so... I'm just attempting this raw. Is he on his own? Please be on his own. Although two of his buttons... I just picked up two randomers here. I'm just ping-ponging between these two. Okay, so our guy here, his people haven't respawned. He's still only got one, so that's not too bad. Get the hell off me, you fucking pair of idiots. Now, this game looks pretty nice at night, but it looks even better during the day when you've got all the... you know, your classic sunshine deserty effects. Okay, so if you kick people's asses enough, they will eventually, like, retreat out of fear. My car is, like, already on fire again. Oh, are you for real? Oh, I wasn't paying attention. Shit. Hurry. Oh, that looks great. Come on. Okay, I'm beginning to think I may not have been appropriately leveled or armored for this convoy. This stream has not been going super well, guys, I'll be honest. Kind of gotten my ass kicked. I've been not doing super well at talking and playing, and I've also not been doing super well at just playing. So I'm probably not doing a good job of selling this game, but I do sincerely think it's worth picking up. Alright, so this guy's not too far ahead. Let's try this one more time. So the screen is all faded because my car is healthy, but I am not. Oh, what? Okay, so I guess, again, okay, I am most certainly not leveled up for this convoy because basically I harpooned that guy and I just put the foot on the pedal to kind of speed past him and tear some of his shit off. And what happened is basically he was too heavy and I could not do that. So the end result is, oh, come on. No! Oh my god. This stream is cursed. I am now way off the convoy track. Okay, by the time I get back to that convoy, oh, I'm near a base. Oh my god. Oh, God, this... Oh, my God. Hang on, I'm gonna pull over. Right, fuck this. I gotta drink water because this fucking black and white filter is annoying the shit out of me. There we go. Okay. Okay, class, let's review what went wrong there. One, I tried to harpoon a guy and yank his armor off by speeding past him. I couldn't do that because I guess he was leveled up higher than I am or whatever. Two, I had to stop 15 billion times because I kept getting shot to oblivion and I had to repair my car. Three, I let that guy ram me off the edge and now I'm so far off the track and so, like, geographically far away from the convoy site that I think by the time I get back there, his guys will probably have respawned. I have no way of knowing that for sure, but... Is there smoke anywhere? Can I get any indication of where this guy is? I think he might be over the side, but... Oh, yeah. So, yeah, this stream, I have I have done a bad job playing this game on this stream. But I mean, the convoys are still super fun. I've got to stick up my ass on this now. Now I just want to win on principle. I'm going to use the boomsticks because they're super. I think they're always like overpowered, and I have quite a bit of ammo. So I'm just going to fucking kill this guy. Okay, I think he's just ahead of me. Yeah. Okay. So yeah, nice, like, dust effects. And, you know, it's a pretty game. Come on, you son of a bitch. Yeah, I know. There we go. You too, buddy. You're next. I'm reloading, but you are next. Have some of it. Alright, your boss is running away, so fuck you. Yeah, so head-on collisions are a legitimate option in this game. You take very little damage from your offensive actions. So yeah, it's pretty much just when you're on the defensive you take damage. You can ram people head-on, you can be involved in explosions, but so long as it's not, like, an enemy attacking you, you'll take minimal damage. So I fucked this guy over pretty good, but I do have a crew on me now, so let's use our harpoon here to. So you can fling people with the harpoon. It does nothing other than look funny, but Oh, see, that's what I'm talking about by using the harpoon. You latch onto them and you just turn and boost and accelerate at a particular angle. And it's just really satisfying watching the armor rip off. And I think I can use a shotgun to finish this guy now. Yep. Woo-hoo-hoo! And you can capture your moment of glory in photo mode. I really like photo mode. I loved it in Last of Us. I loved it in Shadow of Mordor. I did bits and pieces of it in Infamous. And I think this might be the game I have used photo mode the most in. Because, as I mentioned, this is a party game. So we can zoom in on our car here. We can get some nice dynamic angles. We can, you know, we can slap some filters on it. You know, do all this crazy stuff. We can, you know, overexpose it. We can field of view, you know, we can do all that stuff. Vignetting, you know, let's have some intense vignetting. We can put a borders, you know. This mode is really cool. If you've used photo modes before, it's more the same. But I think it's really cool. I really like these modes. Obviously this looks terrible, but you know, in a game that has great explosions, great hand-to-hand fights, great car combat, I think it's a really nice feature. Let me just get out of this here. So I got two more of these douchebags to worry about before I can get the Oh, here's another one. Great. This is going super well. As you might expect with this being an open world game involving lots of cars, there is lots of getting stuck in the open world geometry. I've gotten stuck under lots of cars. I've had, you know, some not great experiences. I am, once again, if you cannot tell by the fact that I'm trying to fill time here, I am trying to speak and play the game and struggling to do both. Oh my god, this is okay. The problem here is that I cannot run away because I need to collect that thing I just went to the bother of getting. Fuck you, assholes. So I have to, like, fight these guys, but drive in a circle to do so. More ammo. There you go. Where's your friend? Oh, don't run away from me, you motherfucker. There you go. Yeah, so that's another thing you could do is just shoot your harpoon and then hit the brakes. And if they try and drive away, they will,
I'm going. Wait here.
Lose a bumper or lose a wheel or something. So, alright, let me collect this scrap here. So, as I said, scrap is your currency for upgrades and stuff. You don't use it to buy things because there's no actual purchasing in this game. Yeah, I'll get it in a minute, you fuck. Give me a thing. Is that a shiv? Oh, no, it's a regular weapon. So you can see I'm getting little bonuses here for, you know, bonus weapon damage, bonus scrap. You have a kind of a upgrades tree where it's like you'll get more health from water, you'll get more scrap when you scavenge. It's all very basic stuff, but, you know, satisfying to have a little bonus. And, oh, that's cool. Do you want to install it? Yes. So you have the option to install it front or back. Alright, where did I go? There's my front one. And there it is, on the back. They have buffs as well, like extra attack, extra handling, stuff like that. But they're not significant. So, my friends, with that ordeal said and done, we should maybe do a mission, I think. Because... Is that a mission? Wasteland mission, yeah. Because that was traumatic. And I did not do a super great job. And as I said, very good chance I was quite possibly in over my head level-wise and I was trying to, you know, take out people who had better equipped cars than I do. So yeah, Jeet is the first guy you meet. I am so goddamn sick of people doing that. So yeah, I mentioned earlier in the stream, there's lots of like ham-fisted, not particularly good NPC dialogue talking about what a badass you are if you do enough missions. I'm kind of sick of that trope in open world games, the fill your respect meter, you know, listen to people on the street talk about how cool you are. Yeah, people here never shut the fuck up about sort of ambient dialogue about the world. So anyway, yeah, this is the first base you get to in the story, and not really a buddy of yours, not really an ally, but you can do missions for him, and, you know, mutually beneficial. So let's do a mission here before I call time on this here stream. We got a doggy that we rescue in the tutorial. He is criminally underused in this game. You can take him out for side quests where you look for landmines, and that is it. That is the entirety of his use in this game. So he's no DD from Metal Gear, and he's no dog meat from Fallout, I'll tell you that much. So, yeah, he's pretty cool, but, you know, not overly used. How do I start this mission? Let's have an old chat to Jeet. Hopefully, in this mission he gives us, you'll see some more variety in the gameplay. Because, like I said, you got Batman combat, you got some little exploration, you got scavenging, and you got the car combat. So we've obviously seen, me suck at the car combat for a decent while. So let's see me suck at something else. Also, let's drink some water here, because we're nearly dead. As I mentioned earlier, no rebounding health. It is all done via health pickups and drinking your water, which I'm about to run out of. So now the onus is on me to get to a pump.
Oh yes, this stuff is awesome. Even Gutcash was happy to start trading with us.
Alrighty.
We got all the powder we need. Enough to trade.
You really want to put black in the hands of anyone?
Anyone who ain't Scrotus. I need you to open a passage into the Dead Barrens for me to send caravans over. You get me one of the big fuel trucks out there and we'll pack it with explosives. It should make a big hole in that wall. You'll be able to feed your shooter in the Dead Barrens too.
Find a fuel truck for Jeet to rig with explosives and then use it to blow open a passage to Dead Barrens, Ward and Armory Project in Pink Eyes and Deep Fryer's Stronghold. Okay, there's a lot of names here. Basically, these are just the NPCs who give you your missions, and they have bases like the one we're in right now. As I mentioned earlier in the stream, you can upgrade these bases. Story-wise, they're, to benefit guys like this guy, but they're actually to benefit you. Because if you upgrade a base, you get ammo from it, you get water from it. So there's your actual incentive to do it. So basically, this guy wants us to blow a hole in a Berlin Wall-style divide in the wasteland so that he can transport stuff. So let's do it. The cutscenes are okay. Dialogue is okay. Voice acting is okay. I think the writing is actually pretty sharp. It's very Mad Max-y. It's kind of pulpy. It's kind of B-movie. I like that stuff. But the overall narrative is pretty generic. So let's get moving on that.
There's a convoy. I'll show you.
Are you serious? This mission I just took is for a convoy? Are you fucking serious? Let's upgrade our goddamn defense then. Armor. Gotta progress the story before I can upgrade my defense. Of fucking course. And there is no other armor upgrade. Oh my god. So there is basically one tier of armor upgrade, and it's full. That's one thing actually I don't really like about the upgrade system in this game, which generally I don't have problems with, is that an awful lot of stuff is locked behind story progress. That's kind of frustrating. I wish I could just, I have the money. I wish I could just invest. Let me see here. Improved tire traction on sand by 20%. Nah, it's not. Suspension. I got the best equipped in that. Boost. I don't need more boost. Rims. Okay, so here's an example of clearing the threat. Basically, doing side quests reduces the threat in that region. It's basically the presence of the antagonist and his guys. So I got to reduce the threat in a particular region to unlock that. So again, it's gated behind story progress, for lack of a better term, and that is a bit frustrating. Can we upgrade? Oh, we can upgrade the harpoon. Unarmored tires and fortified structures. Pull unarmored tires off of most vehicles, and increased durability also enables the harpoon to pull down for fortified structures. Cool. The harpoon is like kind of overpowered. The only thing going against it is the reload time. The reload time on it is actually not very good. Other than that, it is a badass weapon. It's a lot of fun. I mentioned before, very just cause-y. So let's buy that. So now obviously our options are super limited because we only got 400 quid left. But what are these? I don't even know what these are. Oh, flame pipes. Yeah, cool. Oh, I could really do with. I could really do with upgrading this because he upgrades the car super slow. No offense, Chum Bucket. You are pretty cool, all things considered. See, I've done a lot of side quests, but I haven't done many story quests. And in a weird way, I feel like I've kind of been punished for that. Because I'm now at a stage where I want to upgrade my car more, and I can't. Because it's, I haven't done enough of the story stuff. And I find that kind of frustrating. So yeah, let's get cracking. Also, sorry, I apologize for constantly jumping into the menu. Let's buy. So the same currency for your car is also used to upgrade your character. So melee weapon execution. Radical. All the upgrades for your character are. They're all kind of predictably Batman-y. Lower the threshold for your special combos, extra finishers, break people's weapons, break their arms, finish them when they're on the ground, that kind of stuff. It's all good. The combat is very satisfying. One thing this game has that I think was introduced in Arkham Knight, but if a dude comes at you with a baseball bat or something similar, you can actually knock it out of their hands and take it and use it. Where are we? Oh, we're just looking at it. So that's cool.
There's the convoy.
Yeah. So I got my harpoon here.
Let's
Oh, this guy wants some. Right. Well, now you don't have a tire, tough guy. How about that? Alright, let's get some to fix the car here very quickly. Before we make a second crack at it. The upgraded harpoon? Big fan. Big fan of being able to rip people's tires off. That's pretty cool. So, yeah, my car doesn't handle super well off-road. So there is different. You can kind of pick and choose what you want to put on your car. It's all very customizable. There are different body types and stuff like that you can put on it. Again, I'm kind of limited because I have not made a whole lot of story progress. So a lot of what I want to do is gated at the moment. But it looks like there's a lot of options in there. Let's try and catch up with this guy. Alrighty. So I'm assuming because Jeep wants it that I'm not blowing up the marked car. I assume I'm supposed to steal it. So, let's take out some of his buddies here. So yeah, that's one trick, is you can harpoon someone from behind and then ram into them, and it's very satisfying. So one thing about this game is that everything feels like it has a bit of weight behind it. Okay, this guy's on me. So I gotta work hard to get him off. So he got me, but I got him. What the hell? I got those damn spikes on me. The good old-fashioned shotgun always works. Alrighty, so with this new harpoon upgrade, low-level jobbers are basically mine. I need to stop accidentally hitting the main car, because I'm supposed to be stealing it, not wrecking it. So yeah, let's catch up here. Alrighty. Alrighty. So yeah, you can harpoon drivers and passengers and stuff. It's all very cool. Right.
Take care of the car.
I'll watch the angel. Call us when you're ready.
Alrighty. So yeah, so I took out. So that was a lot better than my first convoy attempt on stream. But sure, look, we live and we learn. Yeah, so take out his passengers, and then you can use the harpoon to literally pull people out of their cars. Again, very cool, very fun, very satisfying. They ragdoll all over the place. It's very just cause. This game is full of cool moments like that. So I guess I take this back to Jeep, and I'm wondering if he'll fit it with a bomb and then we'll go do the mission, or if I take this back, is that just going to be mission complete? Let's see what he has to say. Maybe it's going to pop me back out immediately.
I heard of you. Your deeds, your wars, your car, your monster mechanic.
You've been keeping it busy, driver. Go talk to my little powder cook and he'll rig that thing to go. Boom!
Alrighty. Bring Jeep the fuel truck. Drive the rigged fuel truck to the breach point. Great. Do I actually have to talk to someone, or is it just a case of just go?
The big guy!
Where is it? Where is the guy? He's at top. Oh, here we go. Alright. Not super clear, but whatever.
Jade said to talk to you.
Yes. Don't worry. I will prep the truck adequately.
Okie dokie. Okay. So yeah, these bad guy cars do not handle as well as my dear Magnum Opus, which is the name of your car in this game. Where the hell am I going? Oh yeah. So yeah, this is like a divide between the bottom part of the map and the upper part of the map. Yeah, Pink Eye's territory. She's also a boss with a stronghold. I just got there in the story and I have not yet advanced. So if you're watching this and you know much about the story, that's where I'm at. So obviously I'm still quite early. So yeah, there is a mercenaries style camouflage system in this game where it's like if you're in a certain faction's vehicle, they can't tell it's you. I have no idea what sets them off though, because I have been detected before. So I don't know if it's proximity or time or like rank of the enemies, like maybe some of the enemies can see you, some of them can't, or it's just, you know, have not determined that because I haven't done very much of it. Max didn't seem too confident there in his dialogue. Almost certainly seemed like it was foreshadowing me getting caught, so I'm gonna guess that I will get there.
I'll start shooting.
Yeah, so he's okay, so he's basically saying stay in the car. Yeah, so there's snipers and everything. I just drove past the sniper and it didn't shoot at me, so I'm guessing the disguise is working, but yeah, I'm gonna get to this place to drop off the car, and there's gonna be a fist fight. So you've probably seen a little bit of the fist fighting on the stream already, but it'd be nice to have a big ruckus to kind of get this thing finished. Yeah, after this mission, I might call time on the stream because that initial convoy, I think, took years off my life. I'm a broken man. The world is pretty cool. It's very Mad Maxy. Lots of cool contraptions and lots of scary bad guys and shanty towns and wacky vehicles that are like custom built in their own weird way. It's like this thingy. I mean, look at it. It's cool. It's very, very cool. I really like the first Mad Max and Fury Road. I haven't seen the second one.
This is it.
Okay. There is a bio section that has a description for every area, every character, every weapon. It's actually kind of intense. So yeah, a tunnel between the bears and Great White. It is blocked by debris and scrap, making it impossible to traverse. Yeah, so you know the deal here. So Jeep basically wants me to blow this for the purpose of trading, or rather smuggling. I don't know.
Fuse is lit. Time to get out of here.
Alrighty. Come on, video. Oh my God, are you for real? Are you serious? This game is, it's not super janky, it's not Fallout level janky, this game is still kind of janky. There you go. So I'm going to assume a fist fight's going to kick off here. Oh! Never mind! Okay, I was expecting a bit more there. Armory project available. Okay, yeah. So, is that it? Seriously? Okay then, so I guess I was expecting a bit more. So before I wrap this up, I guess I'll go, I'll take a look at something else here. What do we have anything nearby? We got a scarecrow, we got a mine. Yeah, so these scavenging locations. This one here, the blue drop there, it has water. I need water, so let's go there. I also, you know what else I need? Need my car. Those flares are an unlimited resource. Slow down. Alright. Chum Bucket is a really fun character because he is so loyal and unwavering in how much he likes you and your car. And he kind of just wants companionship, and he's really talented, like all great heroes. I like Chum Bucket a lot. So yeah, we're going to go to the scavenging location, show off some of the fist fighting, I'd imagine, and probably call time on this. There's actually 11 people watching this, which is, you know, nothing in the grand scheme of YouTube streams, but I don't know if I've had that many people watching before, so hello everyone. Subscribe if you enjoy the little bit you've seen. I'm halfway through Tales of the Borderlands at the moment, Tales from the Borderlands, rather. So I'm going to be resuming that this weekend. I've also got Life is Strange lined up. So I'm going to be doing some streaming coming up. And let's get out here. Let's get out here a little early. It is, by the way, super possible and super fun.
As you wish. But hurry back. This place is prime pickings for raiders, vultures, scavengers, and murderers.
Yeah, see, look, I like Chum Bucket. He's funny. But yeah, it is quite possible to just jump in here with the car and use the harpoon. Oh, shit. So I mentioned earlier in the stream, this game has cool visual cues. That little lens, look at it there. That lens flare is how you know a sniper is seeing you. But I beat him to it. Yeah, so I think that is so cool. Like, I didn't know there was a sniper there, only for the fact that there was a flicker of a lens. I think that's a super cool way of identifying something like that. You can tell there's a convoy in the distance when you see smoke on the horizon. This game has lots of cool little touches like that. I do think this is visually a really swell package. So yeah, here, by the way, this is how the sniper rifle in this game works. You get in the back of your car, and when you get out, you put it away. This is not a third-person shooter. I mean, even though they showed footage of the rifle and the shotgun pre-release, it's not a shooter. It's a Batman combat game where you can press R1 to use the shotgun as a special move. That's basically what it boils down to. And similarly, the sniper rifle is, like, in the upgrade menu, it is listed as like a part of your car's defense. Shit. What's going on here? That thing just collapsed. Yeah, so the shooting is not in and of itself a mechanic. It's just kind of a side ability. Are those guys phasing? Oh, they phase through the world. I am unsure how to progress because these guys have just glitched through the fucking wall. So, can I get them out? Can I get you guys out? I think those guys are lost forever. Oh. Yeah, look at it. Oh my god. You know what? It's funny. I've actually had quite a lot of glitchiness on this stream. This game isn't that glitchy. I mean, I said it was a little bit, like, but it's not Fallout. It's not Fallout or worse. Generally, it's actually pretty good. I mean, it's not... I would not describe this generally as a glitchy game. There's just a couple of issues. But they have been highlighted on this stream, so... This stream, which I opened by saying, you should buy this game, it's on sale. But yeah, you know. that's the joy of streaming. But as I said, it is half price. So I wouldn't be totally sold on this game at full price. I paid full price for it. And, you know, wasn't completely sold. But it's currently half price on PSN, so I'd say give it a go. I can hear the enemies who are stuck in the wall freaking out and throwing punches. It's very silly. Also, there's some minor issues with this game. Like, you saw there, I filled my water. It, like, triggered, like, a little mini fade-in, fade-out cutscene. Like, I don't know why that's there. I don't know why he can't just bend down and fill the thing. It makes the it breaks the momentum of the game, I feel, a little bit. And I hate using terms like that, but it does. Okay, so the rest of the scrap is up there. How do I get up there? So, kind of like GTA Vice City, there are camps you can liberate inside missions, and kind of like businesses in Vice City, they will just send you currency, basically, every like 20 minutes or something, or half hour. I haven't had a chance to do one of them on this stream, but there you go. So this is a looting location, but there are like camps that like look like bigger versions of this, and it's like go in and kill the boss or go in and blow up their oil supply, and once you do that they turn into allied camps, and they contribute currency. So I think these dudes are still down here. Oh, that's embarrassing. Mad Max, why has this happened? You've let yourself down, you've let me down, you've let the 5 viewers down.
Hey, the car!
Give the car, you little fuck. Where is it? Oh, there it is. You know, it's pretty difficult to have Mad Max have a companion and not have it feel forced, because Mad Max typically doesn't. But he's no Furiosa, but Chum Bucket is pretty cool, I think. Let's end on a beautiful bit of scenery here. Yeah. Photo mode. Oh my god, these filters are terrible. Let's go default. Is it off? There we go. There we go. You know what's great about these games? Look at the skybox. This and Just Cause. Look at that. Isn't that beautiful? I love photo mode, man. It's silly, but it's funsies. Max is not having fun. Look at that. He does not care. Okay. So yeah, that's my Max. I think I redeemed myself there. I think the first half of this stream was not great because I was doing a really terrible job of playing the game and thus illustrating why it was good. But I think this game is pretty damn fun. Like I said, it's on sale currently. If I was to guess, I would say it's probably going to be on sale quite a lot in the near future. I don't think this game hit home the way a lot of people maybe hoped. And as such, it's probably going to be physically in a bargain bin near you soon, and I wouldn't be surprised if this is constantly on sale on PSN. It's half price now. I think it's worth more than half price. It's worth more than 35 quid. It's worth 40 quid. It's worth 50 quid. You know, it's pretty damn fun. But that convoy thing I did and that fist fighting you saw, if you don't like doing that an awful lot, then maybe this game isn't for you, because it is quite repetitive. But I think this game is, other than that, pretty dang sweet. So I'm gonna call time on this stream. Thanks for watching, subscribe, share, all that jazz, and later in the week and the weekend there'll be more Borderlands and also maybe some Life is Strange. Thanks for watching, everyone.